So by now you've probably heard of DC Spark, their ambitious Milkometa project, or maybe you just heard that Flint Wallet is now available for download. Curious to learn more? Let's take a look in the weekly report. Welcome back to Woodland Pools, your place for the latest Cardano news, tutorials, and the information you need to grow your investment with confidence. Today it's time for the weekly report, Cardano 360 edition. So let's do a quick stake pool update and then we'll jump right in. So first we want to start off by saying a huge thank you and welcome to this week's newest delegators. We truly appreciate your support and we're really excited to go on this journey with you. Let's keep growing together. So last week of the month means Cardano 360. As always, we'll link the chapters below for each individual section. So if you want to dig into any of these in more detail, you can. In the developer update, the guys go into a lot of detail about the things coming up this year. But one thing in the developer roadmap we wanted to make sure to point out is that in 2022 and moving forward, instead of releases coming out just whenever things are ready, they're now doing it in three major releases. February, June, and October. The February release will not be a hard fork and just continued parameter upgrades to the network, but June was announced to be the first release of Hydra, and Tim Harrison actually tweeted that it'll be a series of releases. So I would take that to mean that it'll probably also be another release in October and probably another one in February of 2023. But the most interesting thing about 360 this month was that they highlighted the team over at DC Spark and gave them an opportunity to talk about all the different things that they're working on and sort of the philosophy behind their company. So let's take a look at a couple of clips back to back from first Sebastian and then Nico about what DC Spark is and also their philosophy for the broader cryptocurrency ecosystem on multiple chains and how it can all come together.
So as people probably know, me and Nico have been involved in the Cardano ecosystem for many years now. And we were involved all the way back when, you know, Emergo was really kind of getting on the scene and we were leading the team there along with another one of our co-founders, Robert Kornacki, who's not here today. And we really felt like we could take, you know, the expertise we have to the next step and contribute more to the Cardano and crypto ecosystem.
So in the crypto world, usually there is this word that you always hear like people saying, which is trade-off. So you cannot be the best in everything. You need to like specialize in being really good at something. For example, Cardano is looking to be very, very decentralized and is doing a great job. But other ecosystems are like pushing for different trade-offs. And this actually is something that also Charles has said multiple times. And if you guys remember, there is this whiteboard from Charles when he talks about scalability, interoperability, and sustainability. So we going like multi-chain, it goes also in hand in hand by interoperability. And one of the good things for the entire ecosystem of Cardano is that everything that we are doing in other ecosystem is going to be able to connect with Cardano. So this is going to be really good because if you think of like different ecosystems like blockchain as countries, you want to be a country that's interconnected with other countries. So maybe you can export and import some services.
And that's a really great analogy, right? A lot of times in cryptocurrency, people get so focused on their favorite chain of choice, they kind of forget that there is no need for there to be like one ring that rules them all. It's okay that with the different trade-offs that are done with different chains, that different chains will be good at different things. So this whole approach of looking at it, how different countries and different businesses can specialize in different things and how then those different specialties work together is a really cool and unique way to look at cryptocurrency in terms of blockchains and how each of them can use their trade-offs and work together to have a holistic, better outcome for the entire ecosystem and users. Next in the interview, they talk about their Flint wallet and then they get to Milkometa, but that's kind of a backwards way to look at it. So let's look at Milkometa first, which kind of extends on what Nico is saying here in terms of how they're planning on bringing these different ecosystems together.
So Milkometa is going to be bringing EVM capabilities for Cardano, which is like pretty good because a lot of the projects that are already working well in other ecosystems could come to Cardano. So we don't need to reinvent the wheel. And Plutus developers or people that are like understanding how to do things in the Cardano approach, they can focus in bringing new key innovation. That's like something unique, not only for Cardano, but also for other blockchains. So we hope that with Milkometa, we can bring like a lot of adoption and speed up the integration of like different tools, different projects into the Cardano ecosystem, and also support ADA. And this is pretty cool because unlike all the projects with Milkometa, we are not using a new token. We are using ADA as the base currency. So when you move from Cardano to Milkometa using Flint, you're going to be using wrapped ADA to pay for fees, to use different dApps. So that way, Milkomeda is trying to be part of the Cardano ecosystem and it's going to feel like an extension rather than another different project.
So that's really interesting. Last week, we talked about the notion of scalability for Cardano, including sidechains, and Milkomeda is going to be a sidechain that focuses specifically on first Ethereum EVM and then other multi-chain interoperability, and making it that this is not going to be a bridge between Cardano and Ethereum. Instead, it's going to be that Ethereum Solidity developers can take their Ethereum smart contracts and then launch them on the Milkomeda EVM sidechain, and then that will be interoperable with the Cardano blockchain. And then, as he says here, any payments that are done back and forth and any fees that are charged are going to be in native ADA. So what we can see then is that Ethereum native projects that are written in Solidity can be launched also on Cardano, and then all the fees and everything are paid in ADA, therefore growing the value of the entire Cardano ecosystem as well. Really, really cool stuff. So then the way that this all comes together and the way that people will be able to interface with this EVM sidechain and with Milkomeda and the multiple chains that will be eventually brought in is through, as he mentioned, their Flint wallet. So if we go back over to Sebastian, let's hear a little bit more about the Flint wallet, which as of today has just launched, and get a little more of an idea of how it works and what the plan is and the roadmap for the Flint wallet moving forward.
So the first product we plan to release kind of fully to the public is called Flint. And Flint is a wallet for Cardano. And the reason we're building Flint is kind of two reasons. One is because, as we talked about, we're really interested in interoperability. We really want to bridge to other ecosystems and, you know, technologies that they have and bring them to the Cardano ecosystem and bring our stack to them. And the easiest way to do that was to have a wallet that, you know, will work well with these other, you know, ways of operating blockchains. For example, one of the other projects we're going to be working on, which Nico will talk about later, is Milkomeda. And, you know, he'll explain how all that ties into our interoperability vision, and to really bring that to the masses, you know, Flint will play a key role. But at the same time, as we do this, one of our core philosophies in DC Spark is really building, you know, the crypto ecosystem. And that means that we contribute a lot of open source code, and we plan to continue to contribute a lot of open source code. And so Flint is a wallet for Cardano, but it's not just a wallet. It also encompasses all the open source work that we're doing, which is also being reused by many other projects, other wallets, exchanges, dApps, and so on.
So that's really, really cool. If DC Spark and Milkomeda can pull off these sidechains and integrations that they're hoping to do, you'll be able to interface with smart contracts from different blockchains all in the same wallet. And while with this initial beta launch, Flint Wallet is already a fully featured Cardano wallet, you can already see some of the intentions that they have about moving forward, how they plan on being able to interface with the different blockchains. Because there's little subtle things, like right here, for example, the top of the wallet, it lets you know, hey, you're on Cardano right now. And so while right now Flint is a Cardano-only wallet, I suspect that one of the settings they'll have once Milkomeda is introduced is the ability to toggle and work with these different sidechains, with the EVM or whatever else. So this wallet like just launched a couple of days ago, but let us know in the comments down below if you're interested in seeing some tutorials on the Flint wallet. If there's enough interest, we'll put together a series of tutorials like we did for CC Vault. Let us know what you think about DC Spark, Milkomeda, and Flint. And if nothing else, we'll see you next week.